So what do you do next after completing your first programming course? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And this video is all about what to do after you've completed some training. So perhaps you've taken your first programming course, you've completed it and you feel good, you've got some basic skills under your belt. What do you do next? Well, the answer to that depends on you, largely. So what do you want to do with your life after that first course? So you've probably taken, I'm guessing at this point, if you've just taken the one course, an introduction to programming course, or you picked up a course like My Java Masterclass or whatever it was, some ebook, and you've got some basic skills. So the question to ask yourself at this point is, how do you feel about programming? Are you still as enthusiastic and motivated to learn programming as you were when you started? And perhaps if you've done that, you've got more of an idea on where you want to go. For example, when you start a course, you might be really fixated on, say, becoming a games developer. So you might have actually started this training with the intention of becoming a games developer. But you'll find, and this is quite common in the industry, as you progress and learn some skills, that you'll learn a little bit about different technologies. For example, building desktop applications or creating web applications or whatever it is, you might find that your interests will change, and whereas you were interested, say, in game programming, you might be looking more at web development. So importantly, ask yourself at the end of that course, how do I feel about programming? And if your focus, where you're looking at, has changed. And if it has, then maybe you can start looking at courses relating to that technology. But if it was a games development course and you took a programming language course to learn the basics, of course, the next logical step would be to find a programming course that you can focus your skills on relating to games programming in that particular example. So have a think about where you're trying to go with your skills, and you can start focusing on where you want to go. If you're looking for general programming skills, in other words, you just want to become a better programmer and you're not necessarily at the stage where you want to specialize in anything, or perhaps you haven't decided, then a great idea is to look at things like algorithm courses, design patterns, data structures, those sorts of fundamental concepts that are usually not taught in detail in a beginning course. So keep in mind with programming courses, there's no one course that can teach you everything about programming. They can teach you a lot, and you can certainly get a good overview of a lot, but it's going to take a lot of training to become an expert or to become a really good developer. So what you can do is focus on specifics of the programming language. So whereas in a basic course, you might have learned the basics of a programming language, start perhaps looking at another course that focuses on algorithms or data structures or design patterns, those sorts of common things that are used in the industry and apply to virtually all areas, you know, game programming, desktop applications, web development, whatever it is. So good generic or good general programming skills are very valuable. So that can also be an excellent way to focus on your future skills. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.